The Rival School's Project Justice tradition is we have to watch the intro. We always do. So we're doing it again. One year. This is the bullshit from Rival Schools happened. What I like about this intro is, like, each time is a different set of three characters. I love the manga panels, too. So, at the end of Rival Schools, the ghetto high school gang accepted Akira as their ally. They found out that Akira was actually a woman, and Hyo got his ass beat. So that was a year ago, according to the story. So let's get to what happened after that. Akira got her wish. She's part of an all-girls high school now. She's a regular schoolgirl. But anyway, let's read it. It's been 1 year since Hyo Imawano took control of Justice High School and effort to eventually rule Japan. Life returned to normal for everyone, and people forgot his evil scheme. They forgot about the PS1 era. Akira Kazuma transferred from ghetto high school to Seishun Girls High School, and she graduated to the second grade. She could not tell her classmate that she came from a boys' school and thus was under a lot of stress. But one of her classmates, Yukika Kirishima, did some stuff. One day, Akira confessed her trouble to her, saying she was something wrong with her brother, Daigo. Has just come back from his long journey of training. Yukika suggested that Akira and her should investigate, and so they went to the gang leader Zaki for help, and Zaki's awesome. I love Zaki. Oh, I see. I didn't know Zaki had a real... Zaki wasn't a real name. See, I never knew that. Akira's gonna fight with Zaki. Once again, Akira needs to prove herself to people. That just seems to be a trend with her story. Round one! I have 4 meters. That's the one I wanted to do, but oh well. Hell yeah, Akira. Round two, fight! Am I qualified? Everybody knows who Daigo is. So now we have Zaki. Welcome back. Oh, it's heavy quotations, Batsu. Totally your friend from Taiyo High School. Yeah, Batsu would totally just attack you for no reason. Batsu's old enough to have gray streaks in his hair. But you know, no one can tell the difference, so. Not to mention that's not his voice either, but you know, everyone's just. Not gonna say stupid, but they're stupid. I should explain that. In this game now, when you do team supers, the computer can, well, your opponent can escape them by sacrificing 1 meter, but if you don't manage to hit them by the time the time runs out, they can escape the super. So new mechanics. Zaki's so cool. Momos are short. Got him. Yeah. Get out of here, Momo. Damn it. Okay, good. All right. Zaki's probably one of my favorite new characters. Gang leader chicks are always dope. I'm mad they had to actually confront Batsu to realize that that other guy wasn't him. Oh man, I forgot about Hayato, sorry. This game has so many cool characters. So basically, to get the gist of what's going on, it's pretty much, for Akira, it's the same plot as the first game. Daigo's missing, they're looking for him. And they figure out that someone's impersonating Batsu and ruining his reputation, so now they're going around all the schools. Gets hit by that.
Oh no!
Shit. Okay. I didn't want to start off doing that, but oh well.
Yeah.
What the? You know, that's like one of the best supers of all time. But still. There we go. Are you doing the wrong one? Don't worry about it. Look how much better the art is. And not to say the art in the previous game was bad, it was just like, this is even better. Spoilers, Eureka's up to something. Absolutely. The character design is top notch. He's brainwashed, big surprise! Edge and Gan are back. Let's see. Give my boy Edge back in. Hashtag team delinquents.